I think one of the big issues next year is something that we started to touch on this year, which is how are we going to implement new legislation and what are the actual commercial and cultural impacts on the industry. And I think those will be fruitful topics for discussion next year because we'll actually see real evidence.
The key topics for next year will probably be, again, where the marina has developed with the local areas in terms of how the Filipino challenges from EMSA have been resolved under Marina 1 year on, and it sounds exciting. Looks like they've met a lot of the challenges on that. The others, I think, will be more geared towards how the work with the new technologies are coming into place. I just spoke at Silicon Valley with some real innovators, and I think that will be the type of thing that we could look at bringing in next year, the Internet of Things at sea, how we're going to incorporate these new technologies into the maritime industry, getting actual input from the industry so that we're at the creation of these new technologies, not things that are given to us after they've been developed. So I think it's the input that we'll get from the people who come to this conference on a regular basis to put their views forward. And I think this is the big thing, that when they come to the conference and they can express themselves, and there is ample opportunity for them to express themselves as delegates, they can put their opinion to the leaders of the industry and have it heard.
Well, I guess the most important one seems to be training and how we can improve the quality and competence of officers, especially cadets. But one of the things I feel missing at the moment is competence of senior officers.
Asia is now supplying the manpower for the world's fleets, and the developments of improving competency, improving training, and making the seafaring career attractive for the seafarers in this region, all of these issues have been covered very well in this conference.